Hey guys, and welcome back to another episode of Witches of the Moon. My name is Dia, aka Ori of OriesOasis.com, and this week we're talking about children and the craft. There's so many different ways I could take this. So I guess the first way I would take it is what I always get, which is how to bring your children into the craft, because that's the number one question I get all the time, is how to bring your children into your craft. And my answer that I always say is you don't. You allow them to, in my opinion, everybody could be different, but for me, what I do is I allow my children to watch me do what I do, and then eventually they had questions, which made them naturally inquisitive. So as they had questions, I answered their questions, and then over time they start mocking what I do, and now they start to do certain things on their own. Now, for me, I think that is the best way to bring children in, because it pulls in their natural curiosity, and it makes them feel like they're doing it on their own. Now, the other question I get is, should you do it? Should you pull children into your craft, into your spirituality, into learning about your faith? And I'm gonna be realistic, whether you choose to do it or whether you choose not to it, kids normally imitate what they see. So it's not really about whether you should do it or you should not do it. It's about making sure that you are confident in your spirituality, or at least honest enough with yourself and your spirituality. That way, if your kids see you doing something, your child see you doing something, because kid means goat. But that way, if your child sees you doing something and they start imitating it, you're comfortable enough either to allow them to imitate it and express it in their own way, or you are comfortable enough with them asking questions about what you do. And I would suggest to be honest. If you're saying, you know, right now you're experimenting and you don't know, say that. You know, you don't have to be. A lot of times we feel as though when it comes to our kids, we have to be a literally walking, living, breathing encyclopedia. And we don't. It can be a lot of fun just by telling your child you don't know, but we can research it together. You know, kids come up with the craziest questions. Their questions come from a pure place inside them. And a lot of times you're just like, huh. So I say, just, you know, sit down with, you know, I don't know. But if you truly want to know the answer, we can look for the answer together. You know, if it comes to spells and stuff and they want to know how a spell or a ritual or something is going to work out, say, you know, I don't know, but we can do the spell together and we can journal how things go afterwards so you can learn for yourself. Again, do I think you should bring kids into the craft? It's not a yes or no, because children do what they see, not what they hear. You know, how many times have you tell your kid not to do something? Children only imitate what they see. So whether it's TV or whether it's you, whether it's other kids around them, children imitate what they see. So for me, it doesn't really matter whether I want them in it or not. They're going to do it because they're around me all the time, and that they're around their father all the time, and that's what they see. So with that, I would say be more open to explaining to them exactly what it is. And if you're transitioning towards different spiritualities, be open to say that, you know, say I'm exploring this right now, and right now this is the path for me. And then that opens up a whole nother conversation about what path is the right path for them. Like, for example, I'm y'all know I'm eclectic, I like different stuff, but I have one child who's totally into oracle cards. But I have another child who could care less about the oracle cards. When he plays with oracle cards, he like built houses. Remember, I used to take the cards and build like houses out of the cards and try not to let them fall? He does that with my oracle cards. But he loves crystals. He's heavily, heavily, heavily into crystals. So, and my other one will take the crystals and he'll turn the other one who loves the cards will take the crystals, and the crystals will be like Mario Brothers, or build something like an island with them, and they're part of the island, and or he'll line them up and they'll be part of a racetrack. I mean, I don't really mind my kids play with certain crystals, like the little tumble stones. I don't mind, because to me, that's all good energy, and whether they know it or not, they're pulling energy around them. But other than that, the only other thing I would say is when bringing your child in, I would say do not be too strict with it. Let their imagination go. They're young enough where they're totally connected to spirit, so spirit will give them what they need. let their imagination take over. Now, again, I'm not saying let them throw things, break things, nothing like that. But if it's a healthy curiosity and they just want to pick up and look, you know, I suggest that the things that they're allowed to touch, put it at a level they can get to. That way they're not trying to climb and reach. And, of course, stay in the room with them at all times to make sure and let them have a healthy curiosity with it. And, again, I'm not talking about, like, 1 or 2-year-olds who's going to put everything in their mouth. I'm not talking about them at all. That's a whole nother. You know, for 1 and 2-year-olds, I would actually suggest maybe Mojo. Well, I want to say Mojo bags, but it's not exactly a Mojo bag. It's for the kids that want to put them in, you know, the young babies that since they put everything in their mouth. It's this thing that I used to have for my sons, and it was like it was kind of like a popsicle, but on the other end was a mesh bag. Like this side was a popsicle, but on this side was a mesh bag. And what you would do in a mesh bag is you would put a frozen fruit or frozen banana in it, and that way they gnaw on it. And as they gnaw on it, it was for teething, but that way when they gnaw on it, they get in the fruit and the nutrients in it without choking on the whole piece, and it came through the mesh bag. What you can do is put the stone. Make sure the stones are okay to go in their mouth. Not every stone is okay to go inside the body. But you can put the stones in there and just let them play with that and watch them. And that way, if they put it on their mouth, you don't have to worry about it too much if they're that young. But again, not every stone can go in their mouth. So I would totally look up the stones and make sure you know what stones is okay, what stones are not okay. And still, as always, we're parents, you know. Pay attention. Other than that, I would allow them to explore different religions. I mean, the reason why I say this is because, you know, growing up, of course, my mom, to a certain extent, when I got 15, allowed me to explore Wicca. She did allow me to. I know she thought it was a phase. It turned out it wasn't. Jokes on her. But, well, Wicca was a phase, but I still stayed in that. I'm going left. Anyway. But, you know, she allowed me to explore. So, to me, I think it's very important to allow kids to explore. Even though you may not agree what they may be exploring with, if you grew up in a household where your parents are not allowing you to explore, you're kind of doing this. I mean, most of in this path, you know, kind of understand that. So we allow our kids to explore their spirituality, and I would suggest that's the best thing for them, because just everybody's path is very unique and very specific to them, you know. And I can go deep into the astrological side of that, where you look at each individual chart. You could take 2 identical twins. And you can look at their chart, and their chart will not be identical. Their chart will not, the slightest little moment, 30 seconds, an hour, 15 minutes, whatever, can change a chart drastically. And that whole chart basically shows the energy that they came here with and the energy, and what it is that they want to do with their life. So I would suggest, you know, letting them explore. Their path may not be your path. You know, for most of us, we did not grow up directly. We may have been around it indirectly, but we did not grow up directly in the paths that we're in right now. So you have to think that your children may not be into the path that you're in. But I would say allow them to explore within a healthy, safe environment, you know. I wouldn't say, you know, teach your 4 or 5 or even 10-year-old how to do, I would teach them how to do reversal work. But I wouldn't teach them how to, like, mess somebody up or how to throw curses on them. At that age, they don't need to learn that, because it's going to become a crutch. I would teach them, you know, money spells. I would teach them self-love spells first. Self-love spells first. And I do believe self-love is a great great part of protection, because when you love yourself, you don't feel down about yourself. When you don't feel down about yourself, you're not in a negative space. If you're not in a negative space and you understand like attracts like, then you cannot attract negativity if you're not in a negative space. So, like, it could come, but it's only going to come but so far before it bounce off, because those two energies are going to repulse each other. Did I say repulse? Yeah. I hope you understood that. I think that's a good word to use. I'll try to think of another word that would fit that place, but I think repulse is the best. Yeah. Okay. So, with that, yeah, pretty much just, I would just say let them explore as far as whether you should or not. If you're their main influence in their life, they're going to do it regardless, because they're going to watch you. If you're not their main influence in life, you might want to pay attention to who their main influence is. And not necessarily, you know, do that tick for tat, oh, they have to follow me, but make sure who their main influence is a healthy influence in their lives. Because, like, as a child, you know, I watched a lot of horror movies, witch shows, just like things and that. And what I found out, one of the shows that my children love, they love VeggieTales. And VeggieTales is a highly Christian show. Now, even though it's a highly Christian show and all that, it's still a positive influence. It still teaches positive morals, you know, and while somehow they still ended up believing in Santa, they don't believe in Jesus, which is so weird to me for them watching VeggieTales. But they jumped on Santa and then it was like, Jesus, I don't I will never understand it because they literally grew up as toddlers on VeggieTales. But again, I'm going left with this conversation. So with children and the craft, I say let them explore within a healthy space. I wouldn't say the darker side. I would say let them explore offensive magic or like protective magic, not love spells, other people, self-love spells, of course, prosperity, wealth spells, healing stuff, crystals, stones. Let them explore. As far as other stuff, I will wait to teach them, only because, again, when you get to that teenage stage, y'all all know teenagers go through that hormone thing where our hormones are out of control. Some of us are not that far gone from being a teenager. I know it's been a minute for me, but I ain't that far gone. You know, and your hormones are out of control, and one minute you're up, next minute you're down, and it's just really just a hormonal thing, because your body's going through changes. It's not really that you really feel that, I mean, you really feel that deep in that moment, but then the next moment ain't that deep. So, unless your child is at, like, a steady emotional balance state, which most of us as teens were not, I wouldn't suggest teaching them defensive, the defensive part of the craft. Now, and also, you know, some of us, we get a little cocky, and you know how some people get in a craft and they get a little cocky because they learned this stuff, and it's like they're looking to pick fights, and they always have to prove that they're the best person out there. Well, imagine that on teenage hormones. That's why I would say not do that. But yeah, that's pretty much it. Other than that, you know, let them read books. Let them, speaking of, one second. Okay. Yes, this is going to be a little shameless plug. I'm saying shameless because I ain't ashamed of it. You know, this is a great time to pull out the fact that I have 3 children's books. This is 2 of them. And these are geared towards toddlers and spirituality. This one teaches your stones through colors. And this one teaches, your colors too, but this one teaches more of the magical meaning colors. So it'll say a color. What page is this? Oh, this is the beginning. This don't say a color yet. It's just a question. Do you know what colors mean? Let's look and see. And all the art was drawn by me. And then it says pink. Pink is the color of love. And then always ask a question so that it can spark a conversation between you and your child. So pink is the color of love. Who do you love? You know, it's good for toddlers. This one is my colors and stones. Stones are colors. And this one teaches colors through crystals. So you get the crystal. Why I keep opening at the front of the book? Okay, here go Onyx. So you get the crystal, get the picture crystals, and I took all these pictures myself. I am very hands-on with stuff. I did the covers myself. I took the pictures hands-on myself. Only thing I didn't do was publish it myself. but this one says black. This is one of the pages. It says black onyx is the color black, of course. And then I tell you how it works. It will help you stay focused and on task. And then again, I always ask a question to engage. Conversation. Do you forget what you are supposed to do sometimes? And then, of course, you know, if the child says yes, you don't get mad at them. Like, well, hey, black audience can help out with that. You know, also, I've had a few adults actually buy this book, and they love that book for themselves. You know, they say they bought it for a kid, but they end up keeping it for themselves up on Stern Stones. But that's just 2 of my books. I'm just persistent. This is about children and spirituality. Of course, I gotta plug myself. Durr, wouldn't you? You would, wouldn't you? I know you would. Yep. Yeah. But anyway, that's that. This video is actually longer than I wanted to be. I said I didn't want to do short videos this season, but this one is longer than I wanted to be. So I'm going to shut it down. Don't forget to comment, rate, and subscribe. Do not forget to look at everybody's videos. Check them out. Comment, rate, and subscribe. Well, duh, if you subscribe to the channel. So comment and rate. Make sure you do that. And I will see y'all beautiful people next week. Mwah.